I see so many things trying to figure you out. As mercy opens my eyes, my words are stolen away. In this breathtaking view of your grace, I am speechless, I'm astonished and amazed. I am silenced by your wondrous grace. You have saved me, you have raised me from the grave. I am speechless in your presence now. I'm astonished.
Well, welcome. Y'all excited to be here? Well, five people are excited. Are y'all excited to be here? Well, praise God. We are so excited. This is awesome, right? On a Tuesday night, everybody just fill up a church to come hear songs about Jesus. Give yourselves a big hand. Amen. We pray that tonight really does glorify God in every way. We're super excited. This concert is just packed with music. I love our two opening songs. In fact, the three that we lean into tonight. The first song by Stephen Curtis Chapman. The song is called "Speechless." And if you know anyone sitting in here tonight who has just encountered the love and mercy of Jesus and entered a relationship with Him, such that I know so many of us have. It leaves us speechless, right, to be in the presence of God and to be wrapped in His love and His mercy. And it's right that the angels should have sung, you know, from the top of their, I don't know if angels have lungs, but from the top of their capacity to, like, glorify the coming of this newborn King. And this next song, yeah, you can clap for that. Glory to God. This next song is called "Brand New Life." And that is, in fact, what we experience as we give our hearts and lives to Jesus.
Okay, before we start, sorry. We, as a group, can y'all hear me? You can hear me talking? Great, okay. We, as a group, before we began, so at our very first rehearsal, we decided that we were going to play Secret Santa among our group, but not with gifts. We were going to pick each other's names, and the night of the concert, which is tonight, we have to introduce that person. So we don't know who picked our name and who will be doing our introduction tonight. So we wanted to let you guys in on that and be a little part of our Secret Santa. And so our first introduction is right now, and I don't know.
Oh yeah, we were supposed to do that. And so I want to take the opportunity. It's me. I have to do that.
I knew he forgot when he started the next song. Huh?
Leave me alone. It happens all the time. Look at my wife. She's like, he can't remember anything. So I am really honored to introduce our first musician tonight, and she is incredibly talented, quietly maybe the most talented in our group, plays debatably the most difficult instrument with all this incredible music and all these ambitious arrangements, thanks to Laura, but I want to honor you, Ms. Ann, for your incredible talent. She can actually read it, but her heart is so pure, and her motives are so incredibly pure. And when she worships, you know, it's just her whole self. And so we are so grateful to have such a talented and holy model for us in our group. We love you, Miss Ann. And now we're gonna sing "Brand New Life."
I know me,
And it's really appropriate because she actually sings in my band every once in a while, in our rock and roll band. She has the most amazing harmony voice. She started as a harmony student voice. And her harmony voice is so good that sometimes it's hard to tell whether there's two voices or one voice because it blends so well. Her pitch is so perfect. And we have a little powwows about how they improve our singing. And tonight is going to be special for everybody because she's going to be singing the lead tonight on a song named Cleanse. And it's a gospel type song. And we always talk about what to do to make ourselves better. And my advice to her is close your eyes and just belt it out. So tonight, I'd like to introduce Carla Lemaire singing.
I am blessed.
youngest members of the team, but don't let her age fool you. Her vocals are as timeless and as beautiful as she is. Her harmonies will give you the chills. And for you business people out there, if you need someone to explain net earnings before interest, taxes, depreciation, and amortization, this young lady is majoring in accounting at UL and soon will be looking for a job. She's our newest full-time asset to the 530 music ministry, and is the only person that I know who enjoys Twizzlers as much as one of her favorite things. Displaying her vocal talents in our next song titled, My Favorite Things, please welcome Ms. Grace Broussard.
This song is obviously from The Sound of Music. Rodgers and Hammerstein wrote that for the musical, but it's been adopted as a Christmas song as we reflect on the different things that bring us joy, material and otherwise. But the lyrics of it are incredibly symbolic, right? The raindrops, grace from God. The bright things of life, right? The sacraments and the church and all its wonder. All the different signs and wonders of our incredible faith that draw us in to not feel so bad, right? Draw us into a peace and a joy that this season is truly all about. And so with incredible just humility and joy, we move forward.
You got it! I am so sorry. Guys, I normally play drums. This is weird for me, talking. I'm so sorry. This next song is an extremely popular Christmas time piece by Vince Guaraldi and Lee Mendelssohn. It debuted in 1965 for Charlie Brown Christmas. So a lot of jazz music featured, and of course fits right in with our jazz set.
And featured in this number is honestly one of the most beautiful voices I have ever heard in person, and I mean that. Her and my wife have been singing together for many, many years, and she used to be shy on stage, and she is not anymore. She even placed first in Beta National singing with duet with Ethan Hunt, and in my opinion, that makes her the best singer in the nation. I think. And we're honestly very lucky to have you here. So please give a round of applause for my dear friend, Annalise Abbey, as she is featured in Christmas Time this year.
So our next introduction gives me incredible joy, also a rather substantial lump in my throat. I have known her whole life, and I don't know that I can say enough about her incredible presence, her amazing giftedness, her resilience, her strength. You guys know what that word indomitable means? Not abominable like the snowman. Indomitable, like a spirit that won't be dominated, like a winning spirit, a strong heart. And she has, yet still, an incredible charity to her heart. I used to nickname her Missionary Abby because she just had this incredible heart to give. And you know, the highs and lows of high school and middle school and teenage life, she continues to emerge just as such a light. And I keep reminding her of what we see in her and what God, I think, has in store for her is to bring a lot of people to Him. You guys, please give a warm welcome as she sings, "What Child Is This?" Miss Abigail Liston.
Good evening, everyone.
Can we all agree we have an amazing community here at St. Mary Magdalen in Abbeville? In fact, what God is doing in our area, in our Catholic and Christian community, is pretty incredible. Everywhere you look, You go out sometime at lunchtime around Abbeville, around Lafayette and Acadiana. It used to be pretty, faux pas, but now you see men praying together, women praying together, blessing their meals in public. Even at times, I'll just see men laying hands on each other in a parking lot praying. You can hear testimonies now and again of brothers on an airline, on a flight, and witnessing to the person sitting next to them. There's this new courage and this new fire that comes from this incredible love relationship with Jesus that has just been ignited in our community and in our area. And even an ecumenical impulse. I don't know if you knew this, but there is an ecumenical alliance of pastors and spiritual leaders that meet on a monthly basis to pray together and love one another and get to know each other. What's going on in your congregations? A few years ago, I thought it was nonsense that we would have Christian brothers and sisters all over Acadiana. I didn't even know their names from our brothers and sisters in other denominations. And so we started to reach across the boundaries and love one another, serve together at the Christian Service Center, reach out in different events to try to be a witness to the love of Jesus Christ. If we can't love each other, what in the world? How are we going to witness God's love to the world that's in most desperate need of His love and His mercy? And so, and just in honor of this incredible wave of faith, the rise of faith in our community, we thought here in this concert we would take a little opportunity to step out of the performance for a bit and just praise God and worship God. In your pews, you guys can find a song sheet with lyrics to a few praise and worship songs. And so this next little segment, we're just going to praise and honor God and invite you to join us. So as we shift into that, I want to introduce our next musician. Joining us tonight on the bass and our mixologist, but not in the way that you might think I meant that, making the sound work with all this equipment and all these musicians, it's really difficult to get the sound that we have. And he's put so many hours, his own equipment, and he's got this incredible heart of gold. Just a giant of a person with a giant heart to match. I've known him since he was a teenager as one of our kids in youth group coming up through confirmation and life team. He came back to serve on the team to help us with music ministry. And now he is a professional trained firefighter. Imagine that, a big old guy with a big old heart taking up a career to save lives. And that is just the type of person that he is. And so guys, please give a warm welcome to our stand-in on bass because Mr. Charlie Frederick couldn't be with us tonight. But an incredible talent with an incredible heart. Big Lucas. Lucas Moe. Thank you.
Oh,
The Spirit moves me over. line down because I rewrote it 3 times. And I'm so glad this dress has pockets. So, and I get nervous talking to the mic too. Okay. To be a musician, you have to be driven. My secret person has a musical drive about them that is unmatchable. Unmatchable, meaning that the amount of talent and hard work that they put into their efforts is remarkable. And by remarkable, it takes a certain level of patience and virtue, as well as an extreme amount of talent, to have such a love as this person does for music. And the love displayed by them is put in every time that I've had the pleasure to perform and worship with them. Driven, unmatchable, remarkable, extremely talented, and loving. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Darrell Romaine.
Absolutely, this is the heartbeat, the soul, the bedrock of our community. 9 years ago when Father Louis hired me, he said, John, I want to set this parish on fire. Well, Father Louis, look around. You've done it. We want to honor you tonight, sir, and thank you for your incredible love, your incredible fatherly way. You're an incredible pastor. You're a really good man, and you're a really good friend. We love you.
Drummer boy, that kind of went viral, by the way. But what you might not know is that he is an incredible talent. He was the drum captain at UL when he majored in music there. He taught at North Vermilion, taught drumline, did a little bit at BC. He's an incredible teacher. He is an incredible musician. In fact, our first date, we sat and he tutored me music theory. At CC's Colby House in Lafayette.
Smooth, Brody, smooth.
I had a C at the time, and I don't do C's, you know. So I needed help, and he said he was in music. I'm like, well, can you help me with this theory? I don't understand it. I still don't understand it. But he does, and he's incredible. He teaches me so much. He's a great, great friend, a wonderful husband, an amazing father, and so that is my introduction of you, Mr. Brody Humble.
And also on percussion back there, guys, it's just like so quiet and humble. And then it's like, bam, like he just shows up and he's just so powerful and talented. And I also have known him, you know, since a young teenager coming through our youth ministry programs here at St. Mary Magdalen. And he and his lovely girlfriend have been an incredible addition to our music ministry, both for the concert, he helps with Life Teen and retreats, and another just heartbeat, pounding heartbeat. He's so gifted. I don't know what to say, those camps that he goes to, like he's on an elite level as a percussionist, and you'll notice tonight. Mr. Gannon Bork.
Thank you.
it up for Matthew Boucher on bells.
La lucha que tu hay.
There's so many things I can say about Laura, but since I only have a minute, Laura is not only the glue that holds this group together, but has also just been such an important person in my life, a role model for me, the greatest and truest friend in person you will ever have the pleasure of meeting. And kind of like we've been mentioning sporadically, Laura put together this concert, really. She made these arrangements. She, you know, gave us practice times. She taught it to us, and that takes a special person to do that. And she just has this gift of being able to bring her visions to life in such a beautiful and perfect way, and it just always works. And on behalf of me and the community, thank you for being here and for sharing your gift with us, and I love you.
Thank you. John's name because I thought, how am I going to honor him? And will I have enough to say it? And there is so much to be said. John, I honor you. Right, so I'm going to use a cheat sheet because I'm nervous. He did introduce his daughter, but what you may not know is he has a beautiful wife, Carrie, and four other children. And you'll see him at his kids' school events, sports, and everything. Sometimes he's rushing back over here after a game of somebody's baseball, whatever. He's trying to get back in time for Mass. But he's going to be there for his kids, and he's also very committed to his parish. He loves fishing, hunting, and football, especially LSU, if you haven't noticed. But his greatest love is serving the Lord. He wears many hats in his parish. His official title here at St. Mary Magdalen is Director of Parish Renewal, Evangelization, and Youth Ministry. He serves in the Christian Service Center. He's involved in the Acts Retreat Team. He gives retreats in his off time, but he's not limited to that. He coordinates Life Team and Edge Youth Ministry, and you'll also see him in BC playing music at Mass there too. John has been playing the guitar, what I understand, most of his life. He said at age 3, he was sitting on his dad's lap, and his dad would do the fingering on the chords, and he would strum. But by age 5, he was playing the guitar. And then he continued, he played, I didn't know this, he just told me he played clarinet in school and saxophone. And I've seen him pick out music on the keyboard, just that he's been kind of putting together. So he's very, very talented. And he said how when he started the music ministry, but we are so blessed to have him directing this ministry. There's a lot of talent in this group, but without him directing a lot of what we do, the ministry wouldn't be like it is, and he just moved boldly into all that he was called to do. So John, I just want to say you're a gift to your family and this church, and to all of us especially, and I introduce you to John Listy.
Amen. Go and tell. And it's a real, just a privilege. It's a burden at times, but it's an incredible privilege to go and tell. That he's not just in a manger, but that he's in our hearts, like y'all, he's been born into us at our baptism, stirred up into fire and confirmation, and we receive him every week, every day, in the Word of God, in the Holy Eucharist, in and among each other. Do you know that Christ is truly present in more than just one place? Surely in the Eucharist, right? In the Word of God. In our clergy, our priests, when they stand in the person of Christ to administer the sacraments. Did you know he's also present where two or more are gathered in his name, right? The Word of God says. And also, whatever you do to the least of these, you do to me. He is present, truly there in the poor. 5 places we know for sure, Jesus is present. Christ is born. Go and tell. It is such a joy to be part of this community, to see this community rise in faith, to see this community emboldened by the Word of God and by the love of Jesus and by the love and support of one another. Like my phone is blowing up all day long with text threads. Pray for this person. Let's pray for that person. Let's show up and love this person. Let's help this person. It's absolutely amazing. It's absolutely amazing. It's humbling and a miracle to behold. And so with this last song, we honor you. our St. Mary Magdalene, Abbeville, Vermilion Parish, Lafayette, and beyond, our Christian and Catholic Christian community. Christ is born. Go and tell. I almost forgot to mention